Hey guys, welcome to the weekly reading for the sign of Gemini.
Okay, we have the Seven of Wands here. We have the Queen of Cups, Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio energy. Two of Pentacles. Somebody could be guarding their heart at this time. Clarify. Okay, we have the Fool, Aquarius energy. Clarify the Seven of Wands. Okay, two wanted to come out, but we have Manifesting You and we have Cannot Be Trusted. Yeah, I told you, somebody's guarding. Ooh. You know what? For some of you, you blocked this person because you, yeah, for some of you, you've blocked somebody. For others of you, somebody's trying to manifest you back. So you guys can feel this person tugging on your energy. You could feel the telepathy is very strong right now, the dreams, the synchronicities, the songs, all that shit may be very strong right now when it comes to this person. And it's because they are trying to get you to reach out to them or to unblock them, or like you feel that energetic pull from this person, okay? But I think you guys are guarding your heart because you know that you do have a soft spot for this person, or you know that they do like to play on your emotions. You know that you can possibly not trust this person at this time. You know that they make false promises. You know that they wear masks. Yeah. You know that this person will try to, like, you know, I don't know how else to put it. Play on your weaknesses. Play on your, you know, your the emotions that they have for you, okay? Clarify the Queen of Cups. We have the Page of Swords. So somebody could be curious to know how you feel. Or you guys could have a water sign that's watching you. Clarify the Two of Pentacles. We have the Cold as Ice. Yeah, I do feel like somebody is wanting to know, like, how you feel. I do feel like somebody was juggling you and they were sending you mixed signals. It was very obviously very inconsiderate for them to juggle you. Clarifying the, see, look at this, the hiding feelings. Somebody feels like you're keeping your feelings very under wraps right now. Like if you do love this person still, if you do love, you know, have feelings and emotions for them still, you're not letting them know. And I don't think that somebody likes this. Okay. I think that it's actually making someone feel very insecure. It's funny because this is somebody that wants you to be all open and emotion, you know, vulnerable with your emotions to, you know, for them. But at the same time, this is possibly somebody that doesn't want to be vulnerable with you. Goodness. Yeah, somebody feels like you just, they're curious. They're spying on you. They're trying to figure out what's going on with you. Tell me more about what this means for my collective. So we have the Hierophant and we have the Ace of Swords. Okay, what's this have to do with my collective though? The Two of Swords. So somebody was confused about whether or not they wanted to offer you a commitment or not. But with the Ace of Swords, or this is you guys, you may not know if you want commitment, but somebody was confused about whether or not they wanted a commitment or not. With the Ace of Swords, they have gotten the clarity that they've made a decision, or they've gotten the clarity that they need to make this decision. Yeah, vulnerable and loved. Love exposes the truth. So they all ripped apart. We have the Six of Pentacles. What about the Six of Pentacles? The Knight of Wands. Okay. This person has regrets. They regret not giving you an equal give and take or a fair. They feel like they were not fair towards you. They feel like they didn't give you something reciprocal and balanced. They regret the breakup. They regret all of it. They regret being a player and being lustful, if that's what, or just being very unstable, wishy-washy in and out of your life. Tell me more. We have the Four of Swords. What about the Four of Swords? I'm telling you, with the Four of Swords and the what's the tea, somebody feels like you pulled your energy all the fucking way back, okay? And somebody's like, what's going on here? This person's like, I don't think this person is used to you being this quiet. They're not used to you being this stoic. They're not used to you being this cold, or, you know, unemotional, or not. Maybe some of you guys would act on emotion, right? Now some of you guys are being more illogical, right? So yeah, look at this. Magician. Somebody is Virgo, Gemini, Aries energy. Somebody is trying to get you to like open up to them, express something to them. And they're not doing it by like, they're not, I mean, they could start blowing up your phone and doing shit like that, showing up at your house, but it's more so like energetically, right? They are tugging on your, you could be even seeing this person in your dreams. Like there is a lot of energetic like tugging going on here. They're trying to manifest you. Yeah. This person kind of wants to argue with you, or maybe like this person's trying to manifest some type of toxic shit here. I don't know if like you would normally come in trying to argue with them, or if, you know, you would come back and it would turn into an argument or something like that, but they're trying to get you to come in and kind of like, or somebody's trying to resist doing this or something like that. Tell me more. Yeah, the Knight of Swords. What about the Knight of Swords? I'm telling you, somebody may be trying to come in towards you. And why are they coming in to argue with you? Cancer energy. The Eight of Pentacles, because the Queen of Wands. What about the Queen of Wands? The Ten of Cups. This person. Okay, what's this have to do with my collective? The Queen of Wands and the Ten of Cups. The Page of Wands. What about the Page of Wands? They want to talk to you about how they have a new perspective and how they view you as their happily ever after. This person doesn't know how to go about things the right way. They don't. This person does not know. They do not approach situations in the right way. I see them coming in and it turning into an argument when really if they were, you know, being honest and vulnerable, they would just tell you that, you know, they see you as the one and they want to build a family with you and they see happiness with you, but that you are a catch. Oh, so somebody is, their ego won't let them tell you that they're afraid of losing you, that they know that you're, you know, a high value person, that you're a catch. Why is the devil here? That they're freaking obsessed with you. Somebody does not want you to know that they're obsessed with you. Yeah, and like how special you are, how like unique you are, how much of a hot commodity you are, or something like that. Somebody does not want you to know how obsessed they are with you. Capricorn energy. Yeah, what we have, how much they want to spend time with you. This is somebody that's trying to hold back from you, okay? Hoping that gets you to come towards them, or that they can manifest you to be the one to make the first move. Because this is somebody that knows that you're a catch. They're obsessed with you. They want to spend time with you, but they don't want to come towards you and tell you that. They want to keep, they're wearing a mask here. Three of Pentacles and the King of Swords, okay? And the Ten of Swords. What's that do with my collective? Children. What about children in my collective? Sexual encounter. What's that do with my collective? Ten of Wands. For some of you, what is this clarity? The King of Swords, that they need to get their life together? Yeah, that they need to cut somebody off here. Yeah, I'm telling you, something came to an end. Ten of Swords, Ten of Wands, Ten of Swords, something is coming to an end here. It could have been somebody that they were just had a sexual bond with, and then it could have been children involved as well. So they have gained clarity that there's somebody that, and it could be somebody that they work with, or somebody that they're working on, so they tried to work on something with, or something like that, but collaborate with. They're realizing that they need to release that person. But what does that have to do with you? Oh, money focus. So somebody that they were dealing with, they chose money over love, or they felt like they had to be with that. But see, this is the card that I saw when I was shuffling. Mind games, betrayal, and toxic love. I told you something is coming to an end that is very toxic. I do feel like, has it ended, spirit? Or is it, I see a lot of tens here. Has it ended? Temperance? What about temperance? Frozen. I don't think it has. Not yet. Yeah. I heard it's a matter of time. So what I see, like the ending, but what is causing the ending? What's causing the ending here? The Seven of Swords? What about the Seven of Swords? The Ripped Apart. Vulnerable. Somebody's about to reveal that somebody has been hiding their feelings and emotions. And what's that mean for my collective? What's it mean for my collective? The World? Something's coming to an end. What's this have to do with this person? They have a new, okay, what are they sacrificing? Yeah, the conflict. They're coming out of conflict here. But what does this have to do with you though? Seven of Swords, Ripped Apart, World. What's that do with my collective? The Eight of Wands and the Three of Wands. They want to manifest taking things to the next level with you. But what about this other situation that they need to let go of? The Ten of Pentacles. Yeah, I saw that when I was shuffling. What about the Ten of Pentacles? The High Priestess, Pisces energy, the Sun, Leo energy, and it's time. It's time to what? Seven of Pentacles. Reevaluate something to look, to think about the long term and think about if that situation is in a, yeah. So what's that have to do with, yeah. I feel like somebody's been trying to prolong the inevitable. Like something, they already know something is over, or that they don't want somebody, but they've been trying to prolong the inevitable. And I feel like they've been trying to run from making a decision here. But it says divine intervention, no more running. It's like they're being forced to take a look at a situation that They've been trying. It's almost like, how do I explain this to you guys? If this was somebody that was juggling you in another situation, I feel like they were avoiding coming to terms with the reality of that other situation. Like, instead of facing it head on and ending it and clearing it from their life, 11-11 on the camera, they were just kind of like not handling it. Like, just kind of like not doing, I don't know how to explain it to you, but it's almost like now they're being forced to take a look at that situation and be like, okay, what are you going to do about this? It's time. You have to make a decision. You can't run from this any longer. Are you going to keep holding on to this situation? Like, what are you going to do? Tell me more about what's making them, they're not able to run from this anymore. The Ace of Wands, look at the Ace of Wands, the Ace of Pentacles, the Five of Cups. This person just, they see a new beginning with you. They have a lot of passion for you. They see stability with you. Like, they kind of see it all with you. And, oh, it's almost kind of like just encountering you and having this experience that they've had with you is forcing them to finally get serious about something that they've been putting on the back burner about handling. So, like, for example, just say they have been in some type of long-term commitment with somebody. They know that like, them and this person are pretty much already not together, but 12-12 on the camera, but they, you know, they just maybe live in the same house still, but there's no love there. It's very toxic. You know, there's money and finances tied up, but they already know they don't want to be with this person. That person, you know, it's just they haven't been doing that final step, like moving out or splitting the assets or whatever, filing for the divorce, like whatever it is. And I feel like it's like, it's already over, but they've been trying to avoid like completely putting an end to something. And I don't know why. Why is that? What about the Nine of Cups? The Queen of Pentacles. But why have they been trying to avoid that? Mirroring? What have they been trying to avoid, Spirit? Undecided. What if they don't know? What is undecided? Oh, this person wasn't sure if they were ready to grow up. Yeah, so this person wasn't sure if they were ready to make those healthy choices. They weren't sure if they were ready to heal. They weren't sure if they were ready to, like, put on their big boy, big girl pants and step up, right? To be, yeah, like, it's like, they know, yeah, to be, like, to offer you something solid and committed here. Nine of Pentacles. Yeah, Four of Pentacles. This person worries about their financial stability here. Yeah. What is the Wheel of Fortune? Sag and Pisces energy. Strengths. Yeah, someone's finally finding the strength here. What about the Three of Cups? To leave a third party behind. Yeah, to leave somebody behind and pursue new love. Ace of Cups on the back of the deck. And yeah, it's like when they do make this decision, they're going to come towards you very quickly. I don't kind of like that Knight of Swords energy though, because it's like they're already detached from this other person. It's just like they've just been avoiding, like, completely severing ties with somebody. I don't really know why, but it could just be that, you know, they weren't ready to grow up, or they weren't ready to face certain things, heal. They don't like change. It could be a lot of different things. It's their comfort zone. There was some sense of stability and comfort there, but it's toxic, and they've met you, and they know that you're a catch. It's like, they know now. It's like almost like before, they didn't see that there was anything better than that, right? Somebody else had a reading like this recently. I don't remember who it was, but it's almost like at some point they didn't see that there was something better out there. Like, they were like, this is as good as it's going to get for me. And then they encountered you, and they're like, oh, shit. You know what I mean? Like, it gets much better. There is something much better than this out there for me. So it's just all about, and now, like, since they see that there's something much better out there, they can never be satisfied where they used to be comfortable. And it's just all about, been about, are they ready to leave all that shit behind and take a leap of faith on this connection? But we do have the Fool here. So I do see leap of faith energy. It's like they were settling because they thought that there wasn't anything better out there for them. And then they met you, and now they know that that's there. And it's like almost like that's what's kind of forcing this person to, like, they're not able to run from growing up and making those big boy, big girl decisions. You know what I mean? Because they feel uncomfortable. Where they used to feel comfortable, they're feeling very uncomfortable. And it's because they've encountered you. Does that make sense? So, yeah, we have passion ignited. Their intense sexual desire towards you is making it hard for them to know the difference between lust and love. Maybe they were also confused about whether or not they actually had genuine feel love for you, or if this was just, like, sexual. Yeah, resistance. They need time to answer the call of their soul to step into higher levels of consciousness. Yeah, stuck in a loop. A pattern has become familiar to them and they are wanting to break free from the same loop they keep repeating. We have unspoken love. Yeah, they've been carrying a torch for you all alone, unable to confess their love due to the fear of rejection. Innocence. Your innocence and kind heart makes them love you, but feel they must push you away to protect you from themselves. Alt wounds. Yeah, they had a lot of healing and work to do. Their unhealed childhood wounds prevent them from forming meaningful and long-lasting relationships. Yeah, overflow. Their heart is overflowing with love so much it scares them because their love for you has no end. Okay, we have two that wanted to come out, and then we're going to... I'm telling you, investigating, this person knows they messed up with you. Leaving you out in the cold has been one of their biggest regrets, which has made them lose hope in the situation. Yeah, they could have chose sex over the connection with you or something like a lustful desire or something like that. We have investigating. Yep. They're secretly snooping around and asking friends about you in order to see if you're dating someone new. So they think since you're so detached from them emotionally, you're not giving them any emotional reactions. That means that you must have your emotions invested in somebody else, or there must be somebody else you're dealing with. Their soul recognized your soul from the moment they met you. They knew you were the one they'd been waiting for. Well, they fumbled it. Now they're trying to figure out how they can get you back because this person knows that they can't come back the way that they did before. But they know that they don't want you to give up on this because now they feel like the two of you can be a power couple if y'all can get it together. But they're only realizing this through going through the dark night of the soul. They're experiencing massive upheaval to help them align with new levels of love with themselves and the connection. So what is the biggest thing that's coming from this dark night of the soul that this person has been going through when it comes to this connection? See? For some of you, they're leaving their family behind or a family situation or some type of cultural belief, value, beliefs, yeah, tradition, something like that. That was also an issue for the two of you. But it says, breaking free, they are freeing themselves from their self-imposed prison and leaving behind all that kept them away from you. So that's what's coming. That's how they're coming out of this dark night of the soul. Or that's what's going to be the result of this dark night of the soul. Okay. Let's get a few more. For a lot of you, the only thing that was keeping them from, you know, the only thing that's really been keeping them, nobody, it's not been a person, it hasn't been money or any of those things, it was just their own mind, their own self-limiting beliefs, their own insecurities, their own fears, all those things, it was them, it was nobody else but them, not their family, that, you know, that could have been an influence, but the only thing that was keeping this person from, you know, pursuing this connection with you was their own self, their own mind. Their wounds, the fact that they needed to heal. And I feel like they were avoiding healing. I think this person knew that to be with you, they were going to have to heal. Yeah, you guys are in separation from them right now. Someone runs away. Honeymoon phase ends. Insecurities and attachment issues, like I just said, begin to appear, causing a rift in the relationship. We have, I don't care what it takes, how long it takes, who I upset, I'm going to return to you one way or another. We have acquiring knowledge. Yeah, they've been learning lessons here. Yeah, open-minded to the connection, researching and understanding this deep and cosmic connection, willingness to be open and understanding of the connection. Some of you guys may be told this person, like, this, we're soulmates or we're twin flames or whatever, or that we have a soul connection or something like that, and they've been looking that up. We have chaser, feels unwanted and self-blames, feeling pain and hopelessness in the confusing situation, feeling empty and lost without twin soul experience. They're going through the dark night of the soul. This chaser card talks about that. Experiences dark night of the soul, so yeah. So now what? But they're going to come out of this. Yeah, I was used to being the central focus of everyone's attention, but your magnetism outweighed mine. And I was insecure about that. So that's what I'm saying. Like, you made this person feel very small or very insecure. And not on purpose, but just who you are. They were also having a hard time letting go of the past or something like that. What's the sentimentality have to do with anything? No, this person is feeling sentimental about you, okay? Like, this person could be looking at your pictures, old messages. They feel like they can't let you go. They're thinking about memories of the two of you. They feel a lot of emotions when they think about these feelings and memories and when they look at your pictures. And they're thinking about, I want to commit to you. I want to hold your hand in sickness and in health. I want to walk into the sunset with you and never look back. I need to release certain commitments and fully commit to you. Yeah. They miss you. This fell on the floor, but it says, I had an idealistic view on what a relationship should look like. You challenged that perspective and made me question my whole value system. Didn't I just say they were changing their values or like, and whatever their dynamic of a relationship. Okay, how do I say this? What they thought a relationship looked like was based off of how they saw their parents have a relationship and maybe how they saw their grandparents have a relationship. Like, they had never seen the type of relationship you wanted to have with them. I think that was a foreign concept to them, to be honest. Like, the only example of a relationship that they've maybe ever had is toxic ones, okay? So, yeah, it says, I had an idealistic view on what a relationship should look like. You challenged that perspective and made me question my whole value system. Yeah, I didn't understand what you were trying to teach me, but I do now. So, yeah, something about Pisces can be significant or something could be happening in Pisces season. Didn't I say the synchronicities, angel numbers and symbols, positive movement forward, divinely guided toward union, multiple messages through different forms. Yeah, I feel like you guys are getting pummeled. Yeah, spiritual practices. I'm telling you, there's something here about the energy and the synchronicities is like very high right now. Becoming aware to intuition and guides, or maybe this person, you know what? This person is starting to be like more tapped in because they're starting to get more in tune with their intuition. Yeah, releasing self-limiting beliefs, working on inner healing and issues with codependency. They're starting to see those repeating numbers and those synchronicities. And yeah, they're being guided towards union. Yeah, they ran. But yeah, maybe. What about fall? Just know, guys, that they've been going through it. Yeah, they've been going through it. When they ran right into turmoil. Yeah, they definitely do have some people around them that were telling them that, like, the type of relationship that you wanted to have with them wasn't true. It wasn't true love, or it wasn't a real connection, because they, I don't know what they thought, but they did have some people around them throwing in their two cents, and it wasn't good advice. They were taking advice from people that don't even have good relationships or toxic relationships themselves.